Hello and welcome. You're with the Mojo Story. I'm Barkha Dutt. The focus continues to be on Aryan Khan, who is now expected to walk out of a jail in the next few hours. The man who got him that victory, well, at least winning bail for him, the former Attorney General Mukul Rohtagi, will be joining us in minutes from now. Let's take a look at the key developments thus far on this big story. The Bombay High Court has released a set of 14 conditions that Mr. Khan Jr. will have to follow as he comes out of jail. This has been a contentious, high-voltage case. Shah Rukh Khan's son is someone who his father has, you know, this entire case has traumatized the mega star, who finally decided to smile taking pictures with his legal team. As I said, we'll be talking to the man who headed that team, former Attorney General Mukul Rohtagi, even as the Nawab Malik Sameer Vankhede battle continues unbridled. Interestingly, this has not been part of the defense of the legal team for Aryan Khan. What will happen next in this case? Will we know the the truth of this? Will fact be separated from fiction? Let's go across straight now to former Attorney General, senior advocate, and the man who finally is responsible for Aryan Khan coming out of jail on bail. Welcome to the program. Mukul, let me start by asking you to describe the first response of Shah Rukh Khan when he discovered, as a father, not as one of India's biggest names, that thanks to you, his son is going to be finally coming out of custody.
See, the High Court announced the order in the hearing itself. So after that, and it was flashed obviously across the media and across the nation instantly. Yeah. So I mean, Shah Rukh Khan knew it much before I told him or I met him. So I went from the court and I met him after half an hour. And then I, obviously he had the news by then. I could see that the tension of the last 3 days that I'd seen on his face had disappeared. He was smiling. He had tears of joy in his eyes. His voice was tremulous. And obviously, he must have been on top of the world. And
What did he say to you?
I don't remember exactly, but he said things like, many thanks to you that my son is going to be out today. So many days have gone by. We have lived in tension, you know, apprehension. Because, mind you, this was the third court. The trial judge refused, it went to the sessions, that refused, it came here, they had been rebuffed twice. Sometimes, you know, hope starts dimming and then you feel God knows when will the end come, etc., etc. So that's what I had seen in the last 2 or 3 days, and he held my hand very tightly, etc., etc. I mean, like, you know, any father would do. That's what happened.
What about his wife, Aryan's mom? She has not been so much in the limelight.
I did not meet her, but obviously, she must be feeling the same thing. And but I must say that Shah Rukh spent a lot of time in our legal meetings starting from the morning of Tuesday, 8 a.m. Because I was in London, I landed in the early hours of Tuesday and I started my meetings at 8 a.m. on Tuesday. So I spent time in the morning, he was there in the meetings, all the meetings with me and my legal team. That is Tuesday morning, Tuesday evening, Wednesday morning, Wednesday evening, Thursday morning, and then the saga ended on Thursday evening at 4 o'clock. He was very much there, taking full part, making notes, giving me notes, which he typed himself, etc., etc. So that was rather interesting to see, coming from a megastar, that he was taking so much interest in.
So he was in, he was involved in the brainstorming and doing some of the hands-on note-taking himself.
Absolutely hands-on. He was describing the past, the background, Aryan's friends, how both of them went together in a car, at what time, when did they reach the terminal, what happened, etc., etc. That's how it happened.
Very interesting. Now, Mr. Rohtagi, your defense and your line of argument in court focused very much on what you said was the absence of conscious possession. You very interestingly did not get into all the accompanying controversies of this case, namely the presence of a BJP worker and a private, dodgy private detective who has since been arrested, who was taking selfies with Aryan Khan. You must have seen those viral videos as well. How come you did not focus on these issues in your line of defense when they have taken away, many people believe, the credibility of the NCB investigation?
See, Barkha, one has to take a calculated call on your strategy. Now, this was a case where 25 days had gone by. Two rebuffs from two lower courts had happened. These issues of selfies and Gosavi and this and that and the dispute, running dispute with the minister and all that, this had not really been raised in the courts below. Had I raised all these issues and opened different fronts, there is no way that this case would have ended in a couple of days. It would have taken a couple of weeks. Mind you, this bail petition was moved last week. The court directed it to be taken up on Tuesday. On Tuesday morning at noon, the NCB filed a reply in opposition. I read it at lunchtime and I decided to argue it without giving a written counter reply because time was running out. After today, the High Court is closed for 2 weeks for Diwali. If I had raised all these new issues, I guarantee you it would have gone off by at least 4 to 8 weeks. Because if you raise new and new fronts, the other side has a chance to give a reply. And, you know, it would become a bitter battle. Then the issues of Mr. Vankhede would have come in. Why did Vankhede allow? What happened? Then Vankhede's dispute with the minister would have come in. You know, we would have been in that crossfire. And I decided I have a great case to argue. So I didn't need any further crutch to raise this, that or the other. If you have a great case to argue, you argue a case and you move on. So that was the strategy that I decided on. And that kind of played out.
You didn't bring it up in court, but what do you think of it? Because this case is going to trial, right? He's out on bail. This case is going to trial. The integrity of the investigation will be a key part
but
of...
I don't know whether it will go to trial or not. Because there is no material whatsoever against Aryan Khan. There is no recovery. To say that recovery of all is the recovery of Aryan Khan. In a nutshell, that was the argument of NCB. That 8 people were found in the ship on the cruise terminal who had some stuff with them. It will be deemed to be the possession of Aryan Khan without he knowing them, without there being any talk, conspiracy or meeting of minds. That was too incredulous. So if they sensibly look at the material, then I don't think it's a case where he should be charge sheeted at all. And if you look at it in a layman's term, whatever it is, he has been punished by nearly a month of incarceration. So there's no point in having a trial qua him. But yes, if a trial does take place and charges are pressed, then of course it's a long drawn thing. And then of course in a trial, because then the pressure of custody is not there, right? And then of course we will raise all these issues.
Do you believe that that's Shah Rukh coming to meet his son earlier at Arthur Road Jail? Do you believe, Mr. Rohtagi, that Sameer Vankhede has displayed vindictiveness? What is your view as his lawyer on the leaked WhatsApp chats that have been made the basis of NCB's entire argument?
Yeah, see, firstly, those WhatsApp chats have nothing to do with the incident of going for this particular cruise, because the chats date back to between 6 months to last 3 years when this boy was in America. So they have nothing to do, they are irrelevant. But yes, it is disturbing to note that the chats were leaked from the office of the NCB, because they took away the phone, the chats were in the phone, the defense was not given a copy of the chats. So how come those chats were leaked? That is a disturbing thing. That is unprofessional on behalf of a prosecution agency. When the time comes, and should the need come or arise, we will raise these issues. But they were not required to be raised today.
Can you set the record straight on the extortion allegation? It's been the gravest allegation against the NCB.
No, Barkha. As far as our case is concerned, my instructions were clear. There was no extortion demand or anything from our clients. And these are charges which are flying thick and fast, you know, and between the minister, between Vankhede and this unsavory, murky issues of Gosavi, etc. But no, there was nothing against us. And I didn't want to get involved or trade any charges without any concrete material.
So as far as you are concerned, this extortion and the so-called witness who has claimed it, this has nothing to do with your case. Your client has no reason to believe that money was demanded from him to settle
the
case.
Yes, you're absolutely right.
Okay.
It's a simple bail case to argue, and we argued it.
What do you make of the bail conditions, which include Aryan Khan not talking to co-accused, not meeting the media? Are they fairly regular, or are you disturbed by any of the conditions?
No, look, they are a little extreme. But as I said, my focus was more on getting bail. Now, if I had started contesting the conditions, one more day or two more days would have gone. Mm. Right? Mm. So, idea is, let him get bail. If he doesn't talk to the co-accused or doesn't go to media for a few days, not going to harm his health. If we find later on, these are not conditions cast in stone. They can be varied. Some of them are usual conditions, that you will not speak to prosecution witnesses, you will not try to tamper them, you will not influence them, you will go to the police station once a week to show that, you know, you're not doing anything hanky-panky, you will deposit your passport. Most of them are routine. So, if you have to travel abroad, then you have to make an application to the court, and the court can release your passport and stuff like that. So, as and when it is found that some conditions are harsh or overbroad, then one can make an application to the High Court after a month or two to either modify them or change them or delete them. So, it's a routine thing. You don't even talk about it.
Finally, have you had a chance to talk to Aryan Khan himself?
No, I have not. And I just told another TV channel that a senior lawyer, by the nature of things, you rarely get a chance to speak to the person for whom you appear. I mean, I will, of course, speak to him after a day or two after he's out.
But how is his mental condition holding up? Somebody in your team would have updated you on that.
I was updated that his mental and physical condition was extremely good and strong. It was
okay.
Not, that's what I was told, that he was absolutely fit and fine.
Last question to you, Mukul Rohtagi. Do you believe that the NCB has conducted a fair investigation?
See, in investigation, I mean, arresting somebody on day one is not really investigation. Investigation commences after that. After the arrest and the lodging of a complaint or FIR, investigation commences. I don't know what investigation they will do or what they have done in the last 20 days. But obviously, if they had done some substantial investigation and something had come out, they would have placed it before the High Court. That, look, what we did was correct. Our hunch was correct. This has been shown in the last 25 days. This has turned up mm. material has turned up. But nothing has turned up. Therefore, I would say that the arrest was unjustified from a person on whom nothing has been found.
But they're not just accusing Mr. Khan Jr. of possession. They're accusing him of being linked to an international cartel. And that's how they have
That is
prolonged.
too incredulous. I also told the court, international cartel for peddling. I mean, people do it as a business to earn money. I mean, do you think that he needs to earn a few lakhs or a few tens of lakhs to earn that money, coming from the family or the background that he is in? It's too incredulous. And there is no material, there is no nothing except talking about WhatsApp chats. You know, these are young banters of young students. I mean, Barkha, we have also been in college where people in those days would try drugs. I mean, try cigarettes and try alcohol. Drugs were not really known, well known in Delhi University those days. Today things have changed. There are all kinds of banter. They don't become international peddlers. Today you have means of communication. You deal with friends across the nation. And I mean, I not that anything is relevant here, but in large parts of America, having this drug is
Marijuana, yeah, marijuana is legal.
is legitimate. It also has medicinal things in Amsterdam and other places. So it's a very different thing. I mean, one has to see it, you know, things with a pinch of salt, the age of these people, somebody may try, somebody may not try. It's not cases of hardened criminals that you just put them in jail because the Arbaaz Khan, take Arbaaz Khan's case. Assume that 6 grams of charas was there. Assume, right? Though he denies it. Assume that he had 6 grams of charas. The law talks about three types of quantities: small, intermediate, and commercial. Now, small quantity is treated very different by the law, and that small quantity is treated by saying, if it is proved in a case, then it can be punishable with 1 year, or fine, or both. The moment it is only fine shows the intention of the legislature. We don't arrest and put a man in jail because it is punishable only with fine. This is how the legislature looks at it. But if you deal with it in a very heavy hand, in a ham-handed fashion, then you are painting a big guy, a big fish, and a small fish or a small consumer with the same brush. That is not the legislative intent, but that's unfortunately how it has happened in this case.
All right, before we let you go, you've represented a number of very, very big names in your career as a lawyer. Was there something about this case with the entire country's eyes, literally, or even the world's eyes on it, that made you feel it was a different sort of case? With, you've seen a lot in
No,
life.
Barkha, not at all, Barkha. Over the last more than 42 or 44 years that I've been conducting cases, I've done all kinds of cases, civil cases, criminal cases, big cases, small cases. For me, it was a small case. It became a big case only because of the hype of the media and the whole country watching it. Otherwise, I mean, I do bail. I do at least two or three bail matters every day in the Supreme Court. So this is nothing so important, but I'm happy that it happened.
All
Thank
right,
you.
we'll let you go now, Mukul Rohtgi. Pleasure having you. It wasn't a normal case, I can tell you, for his traumatized parents, a really big deal for them. As you said, Shah Rukh Khan had tears of joy. Thanks, Mukul Rohtgi. Pleasure having you. Thank you so
Bye.
much.
Bye.
Bye bye. And that's it. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you tomorrow to everybody. Bye bye.
Bye. Bye.
It's great to see you here. Thank you for watching our work. If you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe to Mojo Story and support independent, robust journalists.